Because it was like, I've been given this gift, and here it is. This is the shape of a great presentation. Isn't it amazing? It's crying. So I want to walk you through it, because it's actually pretty astounding. There is a beginning, a middle, and an end, and I want to walk you through it. Because the greatest communicators of all time, I went through speeches, everything. Actually, I can overlay the shape. Even the Gettysburg Address follows the shape. So the beginning of any presentation, you need to establish what is. You know, here's the status quo, here's what's going on. And then you need to compare that to what could be. Now you need to make that gap as big as possible. Because there's the commonplace of the status quo, and you need to contrast that with the loftiness of your idea. So it's like, you know, here's the past, here's the present, but look at our future. Here's a problem, but look at that problem removed. Here's a roadblock. Let's annihilate the roadblock. You need to really amplify that gap. This would be like the inciting incident in a movie. It's when suddenly the audience has to contend with what you just put out there, and they have to say, wow, do I want to agree with this and align with it or not? And then the rest of your presentation should support that. So the middle goes back and forth. It traverses between what is and what could be, what is and what could be. Because what you're trying to do is make the status quo and the normal unappealing, and you're wanting to draw them towards what could be in the future with your idea adopted. Now, on your way to change the world, people are going to resist. They're not going to be excited. They may love the world the way it is. So you'll encounter resistance. That's why you have to move back and forth. It's similar to sailing. When you're sailing against the wind and there is wind resistance, you have to move your boat back and forth and back and forth. That's so you can capture the wind. You have to actually capture the resistance coming against you when you're sailing. Now, interesting, if you capture the wind just right and you set your sail just right, your ship will actually sail faster than the wind itself. It's a physics phenomenon. So by planting in there the way they're going to resist between what is and what can be, it's actually going to draw them towards your idea quicker than should you not do that. So after you've moved back and forth between what is and what could be, the last turning point is a call to action, which every presentation should have. But at the very end, you need to describe the world as a new bliss. This is utopia with my idea adopted. This is the way the world is going to look when we join together and we solve this big problem. So you need to use that as your ending in a very poetic and a dramatic way.